I can't be 100% sure where Red Magic got the futuristic technology for this phone, but I would bet all the UFO sightings recently have something to do with it. And today we'll be autopsying this alien tech to see what we can learn. I've been told we'll see the world's first liquid metal cooling system inside a smartphone, and I personally want a glimpse what an underscreen camera looks like when we take pictures when it's out from underneath the screen. With quite a bit of heat and an ultra-sharp jerry-rig knife, we can slice away the adhesive holding the rather exquisite, ultra-flat back panel to the frame. The only addition to the glass is a small metal ring that keeps the LED flash from refracting around inside the glass when it's illuminated. Smart move. No camera bump is the best camera bump, and I hope Apple is taking notes. With the back glass gone, we reach the aesthetic underlayment of the Red Magic 10 Pro, which is held in place by 20 T3 screws. With the screws gone, the decorative sheathing, which subtly draws attention to the dual cell battery, can be pulled away. There's another smaller sheet of plastic over the lower loudspeaker, which, since the screws are already removed, can also pop up and out of the phone, revealing no visible balls inside. But we do see some waterproofing mesh over the loudspeaker opening. Meaning that even though there is a built-in self-cooling active turbofan with vents on either side of the phone and no official water resistance rating, Red Magic has indeed made an effort to waterproof all the other ingress points, so thumbs up for that. The upper plastics are a little more visually functional with a built-in flash, upper stereo speaker, and an NFC pad. Things get a little more interesting when we remove the turbofan, which includes all of its own ducting. The cooling system inside the Red Magic 10 Pro is simplistically complex, with air coming in from the right side through a thick mesh grate and rubber gasket. I assume the mesh is there to keep out foreign objects. Then, the cool air is pulled through the metal ducting over the processors, which are coupled to the duct with thermal paste. And then the warm air is blasted out the far side by the 23,000 RPM RGB shark fin cooling fan. There is also a rubber gasket on this end of the ducting as well, making me think that the entire phone is water resistant except for the fan itself, which has to reside inside that ducting. Which, of course, is good peace of mind for those intellectually superior individuals who have subscribed to my channel. I, of course, would never recommend intentionally getting your phone wet or testing fate, but it is nice to know that if it does drop in water, you won't lose the whole phone due to water damage, most likely just the fan. The metal ductwork is an airtight and watertight contraption that conductively pulls heat from the motherboard, instead of blowing air directly across it. We'll get into the liquid metal stuff here in a second, if we can find it. First, while the phone is still alive, the invisible underscreen selfie camera is designed to take pictures through the pixels, which at 1.5K resolution, there are a lot of pixels to peep through. But if we were to pull the camera backwards and take a picture without the screen on top of it, what happens? It'll be easier to see from this camera as I bend the front-facing camera back so it becomes a rear-facing camera. What do I look like in that picture? The color temperature of a camera that looks through pixels on a screen. It's kind of wild. Let me see if I can take some pictures. I'm trying to do everything backwards here. And now that we have those pictures, we can see what the image quality looks like under the screen and not under the screen. A little science project you can only find here on JRig Everything. While I have you here though, today is one of the very last days you can order one of my woolly mammoth or dinosaur metal puzzles and still have them arrive by Christmas. They will be available year round, of course, and 100% of the money goes towards my wheelchair manufacturing business, making wheelchairs cheaper for those who need them. And huge thanks to Stamps.com for sponsoring this video, supporting the project, and helping me ship things on time without ever having to leave the house. It's a busy season, and there is absolutely no reason to ever waste time standing in line, especially when Stamps.com, being the holiday heroes that they are, gives up to 89% discounts off of USPS and UPS rates, deals you can't find anywhere else. I can order shipping supplies, labels, and even printers while automatically seeing the cheapest and fastest shipping options from different carriers, day or night, and get everything delivered to my house. I can even schedule pickups in the dashboard. Stamps.com does it all. A literal 24/7 post office that connects with every major marketplace and shopping cart if you sell products online. All you need is a computer and a printer. Start freeing up your own time, and if you sign up at stamps.com/jerryrig, you can get a 4-week trial, free postage, and free digital scale, with no long-term commitments or contracts, just how we like it. And I'll get back to shipping Alex the Accessible Allosaurus and Willy the Wheelie Cool Woolly Mammoth right after we finish this teardown. In our search for the world's first liquid metal cooling system, we must first remove the battery. This is the largest dual-cell battery in a normal-sized phone that I've ever come across. It's also not the easiest to remove, but with some gentle prying, it is able to come away from the phone body. Red Magic has been able to increase the battery density by 25%. And each cell, or each half, has a typical capacity of 3,525 mAh, for a total of 7,050 and 100 watt fast charging. It'll last twice as long as an iPhone 16 on a single charge, and I've also realized at this point that I have no idea where the liquid cooling system could be. With so many heat dissipation layers, it could be anywhere, and we'll keep looking. There's one screw holding down the motherboard, and quite a bit of adhesive holding in the main 50 megapixel camera, and then the main board is finally released from the phone. The main 50 megapixel camera, thankfully, does have optical image stabilization, the 2 megapixel depth camera does not, and the 50 megapixel ultra wide angle camera also does not have any OIS. And it turns out the liquid metal cooling system has actually been right in front of our faces this whole time. I was expecting it to be directly attached to one of the processors, but it is in fact attached to the underside of the housing of the cooling fan, which actually makes way more sense. See, the Red Magic 10 Pro has an ultra large vapor chamber, which is nothing super new. Vapor chambers are typical in high-end smartphones, and especially high-performance gaming phones. But Red Magic is going one step farther and using the turbofan to cool down the vapor chamber, which is then able to remove a larger volume of heat from the motherboard even quicker, cooling down the core temperature of the phone by 21 degrees. They say that the extremely quick transfer of heat is only possible because this liquid metal, which is currently in a solid state and made up of indium and potassium, has an 80 watt per meter Kelvin thermal conductivity. For reference, that gooey thermal paste stuff we normally see only has a watts per meter Kelvin of about 8. So this soft, strange little square of solid-state liquid metal is able to pass a whole lot of heat really quickly directly to the fan, which ejects it out the phone, making the Red Magic 10 Pro the coolest phone on the market, both metaphorically and physically. There's one more Phillips head screw down at the bottom near the 100-watt USB-C port. I'll have to remove the SIM card tray with its red rubber ring, which then lets us pull out the daughter board. And finally, the completely modular USB-C port itself. Even though Red Magic doesn't advertise this phone as water resistant, it most definitely does have protection in all the right places. And here I was thinking that smartphones were getting kinda stale. And here comes Red Magic blazing all kinds of new records and bringing out new technologies. I hope Samsung and Apple are both watching and or lining up for the next loot drop from the alien drone mothership, whichever gets us cool stuff quicker. I kinda like this transparent air duct mod, leaning into the design and quirks that make this phone unique, and if you wanna help support my wheelchair manufacturing business, 100% of the funds we make from these metal puzzles goes a long ways towards keeping the lights on. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.